My dear brothers and sisters in Christ Jesus, I am sure you all want to go to heaven, isn't it? I want not only myself to go to heaven, but also all my relatives, friends, all the parishioners to whom I have preached. We are told in heaven there will be a lot of surprises. You have heard about the old joke. Someone in hell saw the catechist there. "What, you are teaching me catechism? You are also keeping me company in hell." He said, "It says, talk slowly. Even our parish priest is here." "What parish priest? Every Sunday you preach so loudly and you also are in hell here." "Talk slowly, our bishop also is here." In heaven, we will see some people whom we never expect to see. We will not see some people who were all along expecting to see. That will be the same in hell, it seems. Today, someone asked Jesus, "Lord, will those who will be saved be few?" In other words, he asked Jesus, "Who all will go to heaven?" Sometimes I keep in touch with so many non-Catholic groups, Protestants and other fundamentalist groups, so many Christian denominations. They will immediately tell me, "Father, you should be saved. Father, you should be saved." That's what they will say. Jesus doesn't say about the number of those who are going to heaven. Jesus tells him, "If you want to go to heaven, do that." In other words, Jesus responds to him saying, "How you can go to heaven?" Today's first reading also tells us that God wants all people to be saved. During the Babylonian exile, some of the Jews married non-Jews. So there was a thinking among them that all these people who married outside the community will not be saved. And then comes the message of the prophet: on the last day, all the nations will come to Jerusalem and praise and thank the Lord. God's salvation is open. All those who accept Him will be saved and live accordingly will be saved. And today Jesus tells us, enter through the narrow gate. Don't think if you live according to your whims and fancies, you can go to heaven. Enter through the narrow gate. The children can enter the narrow gate. Are you humble? Do you humble yourself before the Lord? Are you puffed up with your titles, with your curriculum vitae, with all the titles you have? You can't enter heaven. You have to do a lot of sacrifices. You have to live according to the gospel teachings. There are people who want to enter the wide gate as they like, but they can't. And then Jesus also tells him, do not regret that you have wasted the time. Today is the day. Don't later on regret, "My God, I can never find you." Today is the time. From today onwards, so many times, my dear brothers and sisters, we think that we can do tomorrow. Someone told me, what you have to do tomorrow, do today. What you have to do today, do now. That's the way. A drunkard says to himself, "From tomorrow I am not going to drink. This evening is the last sip. Tomorrow never comes at all." Even the great Augustine said, "Lord, make me a saint, but not now. Make me a saint, but not now." He wanted to become saint later on. And then later in his confessions he writes, "Late have I loved you, O beauty, ever ancient, ever new. Late have I loved you." So today is the day to start practicing what we are hearing every day from the word of God. And then Jesus tells us, live in such a way that you will be recognized by the Lord. Some of the people who are shut out tell him, Lord, did we not eat and drink with you? Did you not preach in our streets? The Lord responds, I do not know you. Maybe some of us in this church will be asking, Lord, I came to Ascension Church regularly. Lord, I was in so many associations in the parish council. Did you not see me? I was in the Vincent de Paul Society. I was in the Legion of Mary. Lord, do you not know me? I attended so many conventions. I do not know you. It is not enough to come to the church. Still, you can be a stranger to the Lord if you don't live according to what the Lord expects of you. The Lord wants you to live in such a way that you may be recognized by Him. The Lord of communion, my dear brothers and sisters, wants you that you love one another and live in communion with your family members. Your presence here does not have any meaning if you are not in talking terms with your brothers and sisters, with your family members, with your friends. The Lord will tell you, I do not know you. The Lord of compassion will tell you, if you are hard-hearted, I do not know you. Be off from me. Don't tell me that you know me. I do not know you because you are not compassionate. The Lord of simplicity, humility will tell you, I do not know your riches. I do not know you. We are all called to live in such a way that we may be recognized by the Lord. Well done, good and faithful servant. Come, enter the joy of the Master. We should be welcomed by the Lord in the same way. My dear brothers and sisters, this year we are hearing mostly on Sundays from the Gospel of St. Luke. Think of all the things that the Lord told us in the last few Sundays you read the Gospel and it was preached to you. Just recall, if you are practicing them, those things which the Lord told us, then the Lord will tell us, I know you. Say for example, the Lord telling us, go and do likewise, like the Samaritan. A few Sundays ago, we had the parable of the Good Samaritan. Go and do likewise. And then the next Sunday, like Martha, choose God first. Give primacy to God. Give priority to the word of God. And then the following Sunday, pray without ceasing. And then again, don't give too much importance to your riches. And keep on doing what is good. The Lord is telling all these things. We hear and then we may still be strangers to the word of God, my dear brothers and sisters. Today we are reminded once again about our eternal destiny. The way some of the people are hoarding riches, it gives us an impression they are going to live for 200, 300 years. Nobody is going to live that long. The way some of the people are arrogant, unforgiving, unconcerned about their brothers and sisters gives us an impression that they think that they are the center of the whole world. Other people become part of the landscape. We are reminded today, our life on this earth is a journey. We are all pilgrim people of God. We need to give to God first place. That is justice. Give to Caesar what belongs to Caesar. And give to God what belongs to God. Give to God primacy. Give to our brothers and sisters their due. That's how we need to live on this earth as people who will be finally welcomed by the Lord. May this Eucharist give us the necessary orientation, that we may all be recognized by the Lord, that we may all be welcomed by the Lord. Amen.